Our 2005 special report, Tracking Your Teen, explained the idea of parents installing GPS locators on their teenagers' cars. Parents could see where, when, and how fast they were driving. Now students are hearing about a new form of parental control, a teenager-parent driving contract both parties would sign before the kid gets the keys. This Murrah High School debate class weighed in.
This shows that their parents think that they're trustworthy of having a car.
Under some driving contracts, for the first 3 months, only family can be passengers in a teenager's car, and no night driving without a parent. Responsibility increases from there. In the second 3 months, one passenger is allowed. After 6 months, up to three passengers.
I think if the parents took it seriously and actually followed through with consequences on not following it, such as taking car away or installing such devices in the car to track them, I think they'd be more likely to do it.
Kevin Keene's daughter is only six, so he's got time before she wants a car of her own, but he likes the idea of driving rules in writing. Terry Gray's daughter was 15 when she got behind the wheel.
It wasn't a contract, but it was basically a verbal contract. And we did watch, you know, we made sure that she didn't take a lot of people in the car with her, and because of the fact that she was brand new driver.
At Murrah, this debate class saw the driving contracts as so important, they thought the whole family, not just teenagers, should sign them.
I mean, I follow what my parents tell me to do, so it'll be all right for me to sign a contract. I don't have a problem with it.